Would you help me welcome Charles Elachi?
I have no doubt that there is life in the universe. I can bet you on that. But we still haven't discovered it. I mean, I actually have proof that we are. And the reason I believe there is life is the laws of physics and chemistry and bio are the same across the whole universe. There are billions and billions of stars. And we're finding that almost every one of them has planet around it. We have discovered now like 7,000, you know, planets, some of them somewhat similar to Earth from temperature, atmosphere, and so on. So it's hard for me to believe that life only evolved here. Is it intelligent? Do we communicate with it? You know, that still remains to be seen. Usually after we land, one of the first things we do, it's like when you get a new iPhone, you take a selfie and you send it to your mom and say, "Mom, look how good I look." So that's exactly what the rover does. It had an arm. At the end of it, there is a camera. And the arm was extended and took picture of it so we can see that everything worked perfectly well. One big thing we did on this latest mission is we added a little helicopter. This is the first time ever a helicopter is flown or any airplane is flown on another planet. This is the Wright brothers moment 100 years later. Now, you'd say, what's the big deal? I have a drone, I fly it all the time. The big deal is the pressure on Mars is 1% of the pressure on Earth. So that's the equivalent of flying a helicopter at about 100,000 feet. Nobody has ever done that. And it did come back and landed. And the challenge for the landing, again, because of the delay in the signal, the helicopter has to figure out where it's going to land at a safe place, where there are no rocks so it doesn't tilt. And we were expecting it to work like 5 times. It worked 75 times, you know, on the surface. So this was an amazing accomplishment, which happened a couple of years ago. Now, the next big leap that we are doing is to send a spacecraft to go to Europa. That's a satellite of Jupiter, which is made all of ice. We think there is an ocean below that ice. And what we want to do with this mission is take detailed images so in the future we can put a lander, drill our way through the ice and put a submarine to see if there is any life in that ocean. The spacecraft, which is at the Cape now, that will be launching toward Jupiter and Europa, we decided to put a plaque on it. And it has a poem which is written by Ada Limón. And she is the first Latina to become, you know, the poet of the United States. People my age remember the footprint on the left, that Neil Armstrong footprint on the moon. I mean, that's something which inspired generations in the late 60s, about that we can actually go to the moon. The one on the right is the rover wheel footprint on the surface of Mars. So that kind of shows you the advances that we have done over the last 40, 50 years.
Do you have any advice for someone whose dream is to work at NASA or JPL, either in the arts or as an astronaut or engineer?
Well, I would say pursue your dreams. I grew up in a little village in Lebanon. I had no idea I'm going to become the director of JPL. I mean, I would have never dreamt even about it. But, you know, I didn't come here because of JPL. I came here because I wanted to get an education. Fortunately, Caltech gave me a fellowship, and I found out that the JPL is connected with Caltech. So the point is, pursue your dream. Almost anything is possible. But the most important thing, make sure you dream about things you enjoy. You will get some setback. I got some setback in my career. But you pursue your passion, and I think you can achieve what you want to achieve. Thank you.